Hello, my name is Perrine Kimwright. I'm an intern with the American Peanut Council, and I will be helping with this year's virtual APRIS meeting. And today I will be presenting on the Joe Sugg Graduate Student Oral Presentation Competition. So just some general information about the competition. Be sure to join about 30 minutes early to make sure that your audio and video are working properly. The meeting will be locked about 15 minutes after it commences, just to avoid any Zoom bombing or anybody who we don't want to be part of this meeting to join. Your presentation should be about 12 to 13 minutes in length, and the timer will start when you say your first word, but you are also allowed to time yourself. In a review of today's presentation, I will be talking about judging criteria, best practices and things to avoid, and things to remember for your presentation. So the judging criteria. I'm sure at this point we're all pretty familiar with the judging criteria, but a few changes have been made, so I just want to make sure that we're all on the same page. So the speaker presents paper at volume clearly audible to the entire audience. Student speaks at appropriate speed and clarity so as to be understood by the audience. Students for whom English is a second language should take extra care to speak clearly. Student uses appropriate inflection in voice, hand gestures, and looks at his or her camera during presentation. So this is one of the criterion where a change has been made. Previously it said, maintains eye contact with the audience, but obviously we can't really do that in a virtual format, so this is just so it works better on the Zoom platform. Student times presentation to allow enough time for questions, so about 13 minutes for the presentation, leaving about 2 minutes for questions, in total a 15-minute presentation. Student repeats each question from the audience, color of font and text of sufficient contrast for maximum clarity, bullet points succinctly stated for clarity, text on each slide restricted to most important points. Font size large enough to be read clearly by the audience. Text slides supported with sufficient illustrations to add understanding and interest to the presentation. Graphs and tables easy to read and understand by the audience. And these final two criteria were recently added. Speaker is in front of a plain or non-distracting background to ensure that they are the focus of their presentation rather than their surroundings. And presentation is free of background distractions and disruptions, such as other people, pets, phone alarms, etc. Moving on to best practices and things to avoid. So best practices for your actual presentation. You want to make sure that you're speaking at a clear volume. So even though people can change the volume on their computers, this is just to make sure that everything that you say is being heard and understood. And on the same note, make sure that you're speaking at an appropriate speed. So also make sure that you're looking at your camera rather than looking at yourself on screen, or it's okay to reference your slides from time to time, but for the most part, you want to be focused on your camera so it's like you're making eye contact with your audience. Make sure that you have a plain, non-distracting background. So ideally, a plain white background would be best, but if you have a simple background, that would be okay too. Maybe not neon green like I have here, but just something simple and plain will do. And quiet, non-disruptive surroundings. So you wanna make sure there's not really anything going on in the background while you're presenting. So you don't want other people moving around in the background, stuff like that. And then things to avoid in presentations. Do not mumble. Like I said, make sure that you're speaking clearly. Do not rush through your presentation. I'm sure you're going to be cognizant of the time restraint, and also you'll probably be nervous, but at the same time, it's important to stay mindful that you are not rushing through your presentation. Do not look at yourself on screen. Like I said, try to maintain eye contact with the camera as much as you can. No distracting backgrounds, and avoid background disruptions, sorry. So sometimes these are inevitable. Sometimes someone, hopefully this doesn't happen, but someone might accidentally walk into the room while you're presenting, or your dog might jump up on your lap. But if a disruption does occur, just try to take it in stride and try not to let it detract from your presentation too much. And then best practices for the slides. You want to have succinct bullet points with adequate font size. So bullet points listing the key information of your presentation, and you want your font to be easily read by your audience members. Text color visible on background. So for example, I have this black text on the light colored background, so it's very easy to see. Easy to read fonts. So like I have here, very basic, simple, that'll get the job done. And make sure to include relevant illustrations and graphics. So including illustrations and graphics can add to the visual appeal of your presentation, and also it can kind of reinforce the points that you're making with your presentation. And also easy to read graphs and tables. Again, having this information and this data can help reinforce your presentation. And then things to avoid in your slides. You want to avoid wordy slides and small font. So if your slides are just cluttered with words, your audience is going to spend most of the time trying to read your slides rather than focusing on what you're actually saying. And if the font is very small, then it'll be difficult for them to see the information that you do have on your slides. Be sure to avoid hard to see text colors. So like I said before, the black font shows up very well on the light background, but if I'd used, for instance, a white colored font, then it'd be very difficult to see. Avoid hard to read fonts. So this very basic font works perfectly fine. Even though fancier fonts might add to the visual appeal, they can be difficult for your audience to read. Do not go overboard with pictures. So it's good to add maybe one or two pictures to kind of bolster your points. But at the same time, you don't want to overcrowd your slides with pictures, as this can be distracting. And on the same note, do not include irrelevant pictures, which again, that can be distracting. And then avoid graphs and tables that are difficult to read. So even though the information in these graphs and tables may be very important to your message, if your audience can't read it, then it's kind of just there and it doesn't really back up your points. So make sure that your graphs and tables, if you're going to include them, are easy to read. And like I said, here's an example of a cluttered slide. This might be a bit of an extreme, but like I said, maybe one or two pictures would work, but you know, five pictures, some of them irrelevant, may not really get your point across, and it's distracting. And finally, things to remember for your presentation. So make sure that you're dressed professionally. Even though we're all stuck at home, you're probably going to be presenting from your kitchen table or maybe your desk in your bedroom. You still want to dress professionally because it conveys to your audience that you really care about what you're talking about. And also it puts you in the mindset that you're doing something very important. So it can help you with your presentation. Be sure to check your camera angle. So like with my camera right now, it's straight on facing me. You don't want your face to be cut out of the shot. You don't want half your face to be in the shot. So camera just straight on. Be sure to save time for questions. So like I talked about before, about a 12, 13 minute long presentation. So you have a couple of minutes for questions and about 15 minutes tops for all of this in total. Be sure to check your network connectivity for two main reasons. One, it would be terrible if your network connectivity went out in the middle of your presentation. And two, even if you're connected the entire time, if your network is kind of spotty, kind of fuzzy, this can be distracting for your audience and they might not be able to hear everything that you're saying. Be sure to practice your presentation. I know, but it's kind of more difficult to realize the gravity of presenting when you can't see an auditorium full of people. So be sure to practice your presentation. And finally, this video is kind of just a template example for some best practices and things to avoid for your presentation, but you don't necessarily have to follow it to the T. Just make sure to follow the guidelines and you should be okay. One last thing I want to talk about is our consent to use of photographic images and recordings. This information is included in the meeting registration form and will also be provided to all authors in this year's instructions. The legal language is included on this slide, so please feel free to pause the video and read through it. We are advising you of our meeting protocols to make sure that you understand that when you register to attend or agree to present at this year's virtual APRIS meeting, you are agreeing to be recorded. We appreciate your understanding. Finally, we wanted to express our gratitude and appreciation for our co-sponsors. Thank you to the North Carolina Peanut Growers Association and the National Peanut Board for their roles in supporting the Joe Sugg Graduate Student Oral Presentation Competition. So that's all I have for you guys today. Thank you for watching and good luck with your presentations.